Thank you. It's a real pleasure to be back, and actually I haven't updated that web page since 2005 or so. I'm not even sure where it lives. I'm not sure how I could update that web page. Anyway, I'm not sure where this title came from my talk. So I'm not sure what that's really all about. What I'm all about, how do I do this? I'm not a PowerPoint user either, so. Okay. What I'm all about is tools. And I think that the tools are what the kids and the teachers use, and the character of the tools is going to shape what you can do. And I'm a big advocate of something called software libre. I don't say free software because free software doesn't really quite capture it. I'm an advocate of something called software libre. Free software, in English we don't have the right word because we confuse free as in gratis and free as in freedom. And it's about freedom. It's about the freedom to be engaged, but also the freedom to shape the world, to be the shaper, not to be in a world that's shaped for you, but to be the shaper. And the teacher and the student can be the shapers. And with that freedom comes responsibility. And I think that the teacher and the learner have new responsibility going forward. And I want to celebrate that responsibility because I think that putting our learners in a position where they have to be responsible is putting them into a situation where they're going to be learning how to deal with the things that are beyond school, beyond screens, beyond stuff. Now, like Jeremy, I'm going to start actually in 1969 is the date of this slide. You can tell from the fashion. And with her back to a Cynthia Solomon, who was one of the co-inventors with Seymour Papert of Logo, the programming language. This was the first programming language developed for children in the 1960s. And as Jeremy pointed out, you don't see any CRTs, you see some teletypes. And, again, I'll see if I can get this thing to work. Hey, look at that. There's Seymour with the same robot, the same turtle that was on the cover of his book that Jeremy shared with us. This is 50 years old, this work. 50 years ago, we were using robots. 50 years ago, when a child used a computer in school, if they had a teacher that wasn't just teaching them how to type, but actually teaching them or engaging them in programming, they were programming. And then Mr. Jobs and Mr. Gates came along and we got babysitting. And we got the complete disembodiment of control and power over what you were doing with the machine. The teacher and the child were just there to use the software, not to create the ideas. And so I think that when the theme, to me it's all about where's the power, who's empowered, and that's why the open, the free, the freedom to change, to modify, and the means to change and modify is so critical. You have to be given the means to shape. You have to be given the responsibility. You've got to be given the opportunity. And somebody's got to actually believe that you can do it. There's a dirty little secret. I think I might have shared the secret 2 years ago with the group. Teachers can learn too. So, back in 1971, which was actually coincidentally the first time I came to Israel, 1971, Seymour and Cynthia wrote a paper, 20 Things to Do with Logo. And that paper is actually still quite relevant today, I think. But today we have all those wonderful gadgets and things that we saw this morning and some new gadgets that we actually built at the workshop this week, just 2 days ago, yesterday. There's stuff out there that we didn't have back then, and we can reimagine some of the things that children can do and some of the things that teachers can do, empowered by the technology. It's things that you do. It's your shaping. And so, got to get used to this. So I've got a number of different themes, and what I'm going to do just in part for sake of time, I just want to give you a sense of the breadth that just the simplest set of tools can provide you. The breadth of activity you can engage in, the breadth of activity your students will engage in. And so it's across a number of different topical areas. Some of them are old, some of them are new. Robotics is old, maybe the sensor and data work is new or newer. And you know, the first, just again, as Jeremy showed you what it looked like back in 1971, this is what it looks like today in Turtler, which is sort of similar to Scratch, which you all know about. All these programs all have their roots in Seymour's research group. They're all sharing common DNA. Repeat 4, forward 100, right 90, you get a square. With a few more blocks, you can do some kind of fun things. I mentioned Brian. Brian wrote just about every single version of Logo that's out there. If you've ever used Logo, you've used something that Brian wrote. He also wrote the first version of Turtle Blocks. He also wrote the first version of Scratch, et cetera, et cetera. You should all, you know, either thank Brian or curse Brian, depending on your predilection. With 9 blocks, you can write a paint program. Paint doesn't have to belong to Adobe anymore, it can belong to you. And once it belongs to you, you're responsible for it. And once you're responsible for it, it's got to be cool. Because who wants to be responsible for something that's not cool? So here's a couple of riffs on paint. This is attaching the microphone to paint. So as you paint, the ambient noise changes the thickness of the brush. Try it. It's a lot of fun. Here's another riff that was done by a kid in Columbia at a workshop I ran. He attached color and pen size to time. So as you drew, the color changed, and the longer you drew, the bigger the pen got. You can own it. You can do things that Adobe never thought of. There's sort of the usual stuff. You know, you can throw challenges and puzzles at the kids. Here's one I did around the flags. You know, you have to use Logo to make a flag. There's lots of this kind of stuff. The kids, never mind. When you add sensors, when you add cameras, when you add media, you can begin to construct things. This is a simple program to make an alarm, burglar alarm that takes a picture of the burglar. This is measuring gravitational acceleration using a simple program. This is a game that a third grader wrote. You put the turtle on the continent, and once you get it right, it changes the color of the continent. Robots. Robots are candy. No kid can resist a robot. And there's just all sorts of things that begin to happen with the robotics. I'm not sure why that slide is blank, but there was a picture of sort of the modern day turtle using a paintbrush instead of a pen and making all sorts of beautiful, messy, goopy stuff. Mathematics, simulation, modeling. This is kind of fun. Because Turtle is collaborative, because you share turtles across the network with your friends, it becomes a really rich multimedia chat program. So even though you tell the kids to turn their phones off in school, because God forbid they actually use them to write and read with each other, if once they turn their phones off, they'll go over to Turtle and chat instead. Now, one of the things that I've really struggled with is to enable the teachers, the program, to expand itself. So I've gone through a number of different exercises to allow you to extend the language so that you can write new code in line, you can import new code, and you can also take the program you wrote and export it into another programming language, because my goal is to let the kids reach to some new level of complexity, to shape things the way they want them, not just the way I conceived them when I wrote the language. And so there's lots of opportunity to do plugins. There's lots of opportunity to extend the language. This is an extension that was written by a child, written by the child, not written by me, an extension to the language to allow you to download maps. Of course, we support 3D printing. This is a 3D printed turtle art graphic done the other day. And We also try to make the learning visible to the child, to the learner, not to the teacher, not to the administrator, not to Google or whomever, but to the learner themselves. We present a lot of statistics, feedback to the learner about what they're doing, what they're changing, how they're growing over time. So just in summary about tools, there's it's got to be easy. One of the kids the other day said, it's too hard to program. Well, it's got to be easy enough that you try it, but it's actually supposed to be hard. I said, learning is hard fun. You're not going to learn until you start breaking things, make mistakes, challenge yourself, bump up against difficult problems. So the problem with a lot of these tools out there, and this is why I think the tool itself is so important, the tool might be easy, but it might have a low floor, easy entry, but it's also got a low ceiling. And so we really need to have tools that allow you to break through and do things that are significant and meaningful. Let the kids graduate from the blocks. Let the kids graduate from the toys and get into the real things. So you need to really take these things into consideration as you design these tools. You really want the kids to be able to break out, really want them to be able to own it and be responsible for it themselves. Oh, no idea. Did I push the wrong button? I did. Okay. This is probably the most important thing. Debugging. The reason why you want to program is not to generate a bunch of engineers. The reason why you want to program is to engage in debugging. That's the powerful idea. I mean, there are a lot of powerful ideas in computer science, but the really powerful idea, which is really Cynthia's contribution to all this, is to really get involved with the risk-taking and problem-solving and debugging that's associated with programming. And then finally, what motivates people? It's not carrots and sticks. It's autonomy, the opportunity to master something, and to have a sense of purpose. And if you can provide a set of tools that let the children have some autonomy, but also master something, and direct those things, and this is partly where the teacher comes in, help direct them to have a sense of purpose, then you have something powerful. Just want to thank the team from CET and Mindset as well. It's a great opportunity to be here again. This stuff, it's just out there. It's Software Libre. It's free. It's open. It's free. And it provides you the means. So try it. Thank you.